The Go Higher podcast is provided by the High Program at Wayne State University. The High Program, helping individuals go higher.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Go Higher podcast, where we take on the tough and relevant subjects in everyone's day-to-day lives and provide insight on how to respond, resolve, and re-inspire yourself and those around you. Well, now let's talk about taking care of a pet while attending college. You'll want to make sure it gets on a schedule, gets some form of exercise, and regular medical checkups. When it comes to feeding your pet, you want to visit your local veterinarian, pet store, or check online for the most nutritious foods that your pet should consume on a daily basis. This will ensure that your pet can live a long, healthy life. And make sure you don't overfeed your pet. This could lead to an unnecessary health problem, such as diabetes or being overweight. So, now that your pet is fed and you made sure their bowl is full of water, you can go about your day. This includes activities such as studying, eating with friends, exercising, etc. You should make sure to check on your pet throughout the day and maintain a fresh bowl of water. This is extremely important. Just like people, some animals require at least 30 minutes of exercise a day. Besides going for walks, it could also include tossing a toy or object their way to chase, or having them chase you. After you go throughout your daily activities with your pet, you should wait at least 30 minutes to feed them. If you have a pet such as a dog, take it for a walk after work. Your best friend has been waiting for you to come home all day. This is the perfect time to bond with them, so that the both of you get the exercise that you need. It is also a great time to take a break and appreciate nature and your surroundings. After some exercise, you return to your dorm with your adorable pet to get some studying or homework in. After this, you either A. go see what your friends are up to, or B. spend some quality time with your pet. Doing either of these isn't wrong, as long as you strike a good balance. For example, setting 1 to 2 days for your pet will be perfect and ensure they feel loved. Activities such as playing, grooming, and bathing are some fun activities you can do with your pet while in your dorm. After you do some of these activities, you go through your nightly routine and repeat the same process the next day. Now, when it comes to regular medical checkups, make sure to take your pet for the recommended annual vaccinations. Maintain a consistent grooming schedule every 6 to 8 weeks if it's a long-haired dog. Check your pet's body for any unusual skin growth or abnormalities. Be observant and check if your pet isn't as active as it normally is. This could be a sign of illness. You should do your best to stick to a plan while caring for your pet, which includes feeding and exercising at a specific time. In a perfect world, you won't have obstacles handling and caring for your pet on a day-to-day basis, but college is far from a perfect world. So I recommend you do your best by sticking to a plan. Look to minimize obstacles. For instance, have a friend help you with feeding your pet if you know you'll be tied up. Develop a plan and a backup plan, and you'll be more than fine. But don't get lazy. This goes for caretaking and schoolwork collectively. You cannot start to neglect your pet in terms of exercise, together time, and their diet. Your pet deserves high quality food, and it is very important that a bowl of fresh water is always left out. Likewise, you cannot allow your schoolwork and self-care time to slip. This is where we need to be consistent with making a plan. It is easy to start slacking off and doing things like feeding your pet unhealthy foods, skipping daily walks, and neglecting their dental hygiene. But you have to fight this laziness and remember your pet is your best friend. Everything you do or don't do affects them as well. And finally, let's look at to make sure if you are prepared for a pet. Other than that, I want you to ask yourself, is this truly right for you? Are you willing to sacrifice money, valuable time that could be spent studying, and time that could be spent with your friends? Having a pet can be a joyful experience, but it is a major commitment. They are there for you even when friends and families aren't. Pets provide you unconditional love and ask for very little in return. Thank you for listening.
College can be difficult, but for some students, financial issues can make things impossible. The HIGH program at Wayne State University provides critical funds to students who are having major issues with basic needs like tuition, books, housing, and food. It's amazing, but just a few hundred dollars at the right time can save a student from dropping out or from being homeless. Students should not have to decide between basic life needs and finishing their education. The HIGH program has connected hundreds of students with these basic needs and provided a light at the end of the tunnel for what amounts to the most difficult period of their young lives. If you would like to help, donations of any amount are welcome, and you can find all our information on highprogram.wayne.edu or at WSU High Program.